Hi guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Brijesh and this is the quarantine lockdown content for you. And yeah, this is the next video that we are doing over here. I woke up, I did a little bit of stretching. Actually, from yesterday I started stretching and you know, a little bit of workout at home. It's actually really nice, like I'm actually feeling really good about it. I don't know physically or biologically what it does to your body, but mentally it actually does something to your body, because you feel like you've done something, you know, one step or one thing for the day is done. So today what I did is I did sun salutes or Surya Namaskar, as you call it in like Hindi or whichever language. And it, you know, it's so nice that it works out the entire body. At the same time, it stretches your entire body and you know, you feel really good about it. Today I started with 6 and I gradually want to move on to, you know, doing more in future, and the final target is around 108. Fun fact, actually once there was this yogathon event that had happened of Art of Living. Yeah, I'm a part of Art of Living. So in Yogathon, what we had done is it was a challenge to do 108 Surya Namaskars. And I was not used to doing Surya Namaskar, but I went there, I did those 108 Surya Namaskars, and I even have a certificate about it that I did those 108 Surya Namaskars. So really hoping to get back to it, because I did 6 today, I feel so good. Imagine I do 108 every day. So when I say 108, they are actually 54, like 54 for right side and 54 for your left side. So in total it becomes 100. And if you want to know how Surya Namaskar is done, let me know. I will not teach you, because my form is very bad. Probably you can check out on YouTube or Google how it's done, the steps of it, and there's a particular technique how you do it, but it's really nice. So Amir is sleeping right now. It's so peaceful to see him take a nap. No, we won't disturb him. I was cutting fruit, like we had stocked up some fruit, so I was cutting it to eat now. And it's interesting what boredom or what a lot of time does to you. So these are oranges. See the way I've cut them? Yes, I actually cut the skin off with this knife, and now you can just eat it directly. Just look at how beautiful the sunset is. Too bad we can't go to see it soon. The day has been pretty productive. I did a lot of work, not a lot of work, but that one project I've been sitting on for a long time, so I finally, you know, reached the end mark almost. Now some finishing touches and all that is remaining. So yeah, so I did that, and day has been very good. As you can see, it's evening time. We went down a little bit, took Amir for a walk in the stroller just around the colony, because obviously we can't go out. Finally the shop near our village got eggs, so I bought some eggs at home. So we didn't have eggs for a long time, and now finally we got eggs after almost 10 days. So yeah, that's one good thing. And actually I wanted to talk to you guys regarding this whole corona thing, like COVID-19 thing. So I'll jump right into it and let's talk a little bit about COVID-19 finally. No, I don't really need this. So I want to be the last person to talk about COVID-19 issue. I mean, a lot of people have spoken about it, so I don't really want to brush through it again and, you know, make people scared. This is the last time I'm going to talk about the COVID-19 issue. Maybe this is the last time, but I just wanted to share this with you guys, and I just want you want to know what are your thoughts about it, so you can let me know what you feel about it. So the question is, why are governments making us sit at home? What is the issue? The issue, what I feel, is that all this while the governments were preparing for a warfare. They invested a lot of money into
armies, they invested a lot of money in buying expensive weapons, developing expensive weapons, and you know, they were all preparing for a warfare, like, you know, a proper guns and bombs and that kind of a thing. But nobody really focused on certain basic things, like building hospitals, like strengthening the health department. Like, nobody really focused on that. Tell me one thing, how many times have you seen an advertisement urging people to come and join the army or the air force or the navy? But how many times have you seen an ad, like a government run ad, telling people to become doctors or become health professionals or become medical researchers? None. That is the problem. Somebody falls sick, we need to put him in the hospital. Now, since the coronavirus is a pandemic, they don't have enough hospitals to put people into the hospitals and take care of them. That is the reason why they don't want it to spread. They are not bothered that you will die from it. Obviously, they are not. But they don't want to take the blame on themselves that there was no doctor to take care of you. There was no hospital to take care of you. Our Honorable Prime Minister also accepted the fact that the healthcare in India is very bad. He said that, you know, the healthcare in Italy or, you know, Spain is very good, despite that they are having a lot of problem. Which means that he is accepting the fact that the healthcare in India is very bad. Now, this issue is not only related to India. This is a issue with all the governments who have locked down people and made people to sit at home because there are no enough hospitals. There are no enough doctors, there are no enough healthcare professionals, and there's no enough money for research. This is the reason why you are sitting at home. So yes, that's about it. That's the video for you guys. Maybe a little philosophical or something, but this is something what I wanted to share with you guys and, you know, tell you guys about, you know, what is happening in the world right now. So let me know what are your thoughts in the comments, and saying that, I think this is the right time to end the vlog, and this is me, Brijesh, signing off, and I'll see you in the next one tomorrow. We'll be right back.